I don't know how appropriate that song is. It's called Paper Planes and it's by MIA, Missing in Action. And one person who's not missing in action, and he's on the phone to me just now, is Brian McDonald. Good afternoon, Brian.
How you doing, Mark? You all right?
I'm doing fine. Thank you very much for joining us today on Black Diamond FM.
No problem. It's always good. Thanks very much.
No problem. Man. What part of the world are you in just now, Brian?
I'm actually in my house. Just down in Ayr just now.
Uh-huh.
We've been back for about 3 or 4 days at the moment, so just enjoying the good old Scottish weather.
Good old Scottish weather. I should really introduce you. You're Brian McDonald from the McDonald Brothers.
That's correct.
Yourself and Craig. Now, you've said you're from Ayrshire. Lovely wee part of the world, isn't it?
It certainly is, yeah. It's really nice, so we certainly enjoy it.
Now, we're going to be talking about a show that you've got coming up in Penicuik, which is just a couple of miles from where I am sitting just now.
Yep.
But a lot of people will think that it started back in 2006 for yourselves on The X Factor, but it actually started a lot longer before that, didn't it?
It certainly did. We were doing the rounds for years and years before The X Factor, but it wasn't until then, 2006, as you said, that was our kind of lucky break, if you want to put it that way.
Yep. And it's now taking you all over the world, Argentina, Peru, Italy, all these lovely places.
Certainly has, it's absolutely phenomenal.
And Asia as well.
Yeah, that's correct.
You're quite big in Asia, so I believe.
Well, we've just recorded a brand new album over in Nashville. The new record label sent it out to Nashville last year.
Mm-hmm.
And we recorded it over there in the studio with a full live band, that sort of thing. So it's basically starting from the 8th of November this year. We're heading out there till the 8th to the 23rd, I believe it is. To start the promotional trail over in Hong Kong and out to the Philippines and Indonesia, these sort of parts.
Brilliant stuff.
With a brand new album, so we're really, really excited about it. It's a new journey for us.
Now, it has been a rebranding exercise, hasn't it? Because in 2012, you've decided to call yourselves the Max.
That's right, yeah. We're still pretty much the McDonald Brothers in Scotland, but as far as the rest of the world goes now, it's a brand new thing for us now. We're going under the name the Max.
Uh-huh.
A decision from the new record label and that sort of thing. So it's almost trying to gradually get away from the X Factor sort of thing, because it's a new territory.
Yeah.
They'd rather you were going out unknown rather than kind of trying to go off the name before. So it's a brand new, basically coming the slate for us now, and we're going to give it everything once again.
That's good. That's excellent. I'm just thinking, obviously, you do all your worldwide stuff, but as you might well know, I do the circuit as well in Scotland, and you still visit these lovely places such as Granny's Hill and Hame and Loch Lloyd, Nairn Holiday Park, and it's good that you guys still do that and still enjoy these shows.
Of course, it's like we've always said, I think it's because we've got the roots when we were younger before the X Factor, but we're not scared to take gigs, do you know what I mean? There's a lot of acts that come out the show and they only do a certain amount of gigs and different things, but we've just got that kind of hard-working mentality, and we do all sorts of gigs, from, as you said, the holiday park runs to the cruise liners, which take you all over the world to their recording side of things. It's basically everything for us. We just enjoy performing.
Are you still enjoying it as much as you did in the early days?
Even more so, to be honest, now, because you're going places that you would never expect to be going before. The music's taking you all over the world now, so it's great fun, and we're having a great time just exploring these places and all the different things we're doing. It's that kind of balance as well. Before, years ago, we'd still kind of, you do the gigs, but you do the gig and that's pretty much it. But now we're getting time to explore and enjoy ourselves along the way, so it's great.
Excellent, excellent. Now, is this the fifth album, the fifth studio album that you've done?
This would technically be the sixth, because we did four about three or four years ago. We've released four, but the fifth album we did in the studio was a Christmas album, which was never technically released. It was only on iTunes as download and stuff like that. So I'd say it's technically the sixth studio recording that we've done, really.
And you did some recording in, was it Music Kitchen in Edinburgh? You did some
it
stuff
was, there? Yeah, we're still really in touch with Gordon and Stuart from the Music Kitchen. We still do certain things with them, but it's just the new album was done with a new record label and that, which Gordon and that got us in touch with. So we're always really grateful to them, and we're still really close friends, and we still work together regularly.
Just a question that's came right off the cuff. Obviously, you guys do Shang-a-Lang,
yep.
A Basic Rollers. Did you do that in the studio with Stuart Woody Wood?
We did. It was actually the first ever song that we recorded was that Shang-a-Lang bass at Aerolas, and there's no better a person to coach you through that song than obviously Stuart from the Rollers, who's obviously done it over many, many years. So it's quite funny. That it was great fun to do.
And finally, just on the new album, what can the listeners expect? Or if they nip out and buy your new album that you recorded out in Nashville, what can they expect that's a little bit different
it's
to the stuff you've done?
Completely different from anything I've ever done. It's still pretty much, I'd say, it's kind of pop with a Celtic slant. It's kind of country orientated as well, which you can't help but get from recording a Nashville studio. Some of the musicians there are phenomenal, and they're all steeped in country music. I'd say the new album, it's 50% covers, 50% original material.
Mm-hmm.
A couple of our songs made it on, and there's some other songwriters from around the world that's got their songs on it as well. But it's a very, I'd say out of all the albums I've ever done, this is the one that we're most proud of, and we're really excited to start, as I said, the promotional trail out in Asia. But I think it will be getting released around December worldwide, so it'll be available on iTunes, that sort of thing, in this country.
Brilliant stuff. And do you still get the screaming fans running about after the gigs?
Of course you do. That's the main part of it. There's still a diehard following that we've got there. We're really grateful for that, which is kind of, as you said, it's about 6 years on for us now. So for that still to be happening, and people still to be asking for your autographs and still doing signings after even the holiday park runs, all these sort of things, it's great. You know, that's what makes it for us, and we're still really enjoying doing that sort of thing.
Now, if all the screaming fans in Midlothian want to see you guys, they can see you on Saturday the 6th of October, that's in 2 weeks, at Pennycook Miners. Tell me a bit about the show, Brian.
Yeah, we're really looking forward to this one. We've done it, I think this is the third year we've actually done this gig, and it's basically raising funds for the charity Help for Heroes. So it'll be taking place on the 6th of October, as you said, in Shotstown Miners Club. It's always a great turnout and a lot of fun, so we'll be on there doing our two sets, two performances there, so it's always a great night. So if you haven't already got tickets, feel free to come down, it'll be great fun.
Yeah, it starts at 7 o'clock. There's also a couple of support acts on, and the tickets are £10, so they can be available from Shotstown Miners up in Pennycook. Brian, I just want to say thank you very much for giving us your time today.
Not a problem at all. It was a pleasure, Mark. It's been good talking to you. It's been quite a wee while, so it's all good.
And we'll catch up at some point. I'll probably catch you on some run either up north or maybe even in Bucky if I send you back.
That's
there.
Right. I'll see you there.
Stay on the line. I'm going to play out one of your songs actually that we played in the studio here. And Fiona, who's one of my guests who's coming up next, she said, "Oh, I really like that. It's a Celtic mantra."
Start going right, start to lie. secret place. If you hope to find a way to be strong again one day, sing with me and it will be
That was the McDonald Brothers, and thank you very much to Brian for coming on the show with me. I just played my jingle and it didn't work.
Mark Mulgrew, Mr. Entertainment.
That's me. And,